Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I welcome all of you to our weekly Friday virtual khutbah, an opportunity where we can reconnect with the spirit of Jumu'ah. In my last few Fridays and khutbahs, I've been sharing with you characteristics that are found in a fascinating passage towards the end of Surah 25, Surah Furqan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about 8 qualities that He loves in the believers. Today we'll talk about the 4th quality, and that is spending in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you've missed any of those recordings, make sure you catch them in the archives here in YouTube, if you're watching this on YouTube or on Instagram or my Facebook page. Let us begin. Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inu wa nastaghfiruh, wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu ta'ala fala mudilla lah, wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika lah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluh. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqatih wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Amma ba'd. We begin as always in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the name of Allah. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, there is none that can misguide. And whomsoever Allah allows to go astray on account of their own rebellion, their own disobedience towards Allah, then there is none that can guide such an individual back to the straight path. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions to us in verse 67 of Surah 25, Surah Furqan, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم والذين إذا أنفقوا لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا وكان بين ذلك قواما. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and we will try to break down this ayah so that we extract as much benefit as we can. Allah says, the righteous are those who, when it comes to expenditure, when it comes to the time of spending, they are neither extravagant nor are they miserly, holding on dearly to their wealth, but are in between the two extremes, neither extravagant nor greedy and miserly, but they find a middle ground. Now let us break this down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَنْفَقُوا, when it comes to the time of spending. Now my dear listeners, sometimes we look at people who are just spending money in one of the most atrocious manner, right? You see this and you're like, oh my God, this is unbelievable. Sometimes we see quote-unquote celebrities who would get some type of, you know, diamond, $24 million diamond implanted in their forehead, and people are just wondering and disgusted at this type of behavior. But you see, sometimes talk is easy. When money comes to us, and then it's possible that we may fall into extravagance. So what did Allah say? The language is so beautiful and precise. Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَنْفَقُوا, and when it comes to the time of spending, this إِذَا means and when they spend. So not only do they have an understanding that we have to spend in a rightful manner, but they have that mental fortitude and discipline as well. So it's one thing to not have money and just, you know, say that, you know, I'm not going to be like that. But then at the time of spending, you recognize, oh my God, why did I just spend this so much money on that one item? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَنْفَقُوا, at the time of spending, these people are mindful. These people take note. They have discipline. أَنْفَقُوا لَمْ يُسْرِفُوا, they are not extravagant. They do not just spend willy-nilly. They spend in the right fashion. أَنْفَقُوا لَمْ يُسْرِفُوا وَلَمْ يَقْتُرُوا, and they are not miserly. They spend not thinking that, oh my God, you know, I'm going to cling to this wealth. وَكَانَ بَيْنَ ذَٰلِكَ قَوَامًا, and between the two extremes, they take a middle ground. I'll share with you, my dear listeners, an ayah that is so beautiful and powerful, found in Surah Baqarah, Surah 2, ayah 261. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a powerful example, a similitude, a metaphor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, that the example, the metaphor of those who spend in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like who? Now we have to pay attention. Allah says, you want to know what the outcome is of those who spend in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? كَمَثَلِ حَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتَتْ سَبْعَ سَنَابِلٍ, it's the example of those or is the example of a singular grain, a single seed, that is planted and from it emerge seven ears or seven spikes, some translations say, seven branches. Each one of these, fi kulli sumbulatin mi'atu habba, within each one of these spikes is 100 grains. So what is the example now, people? The example is, you have one seed, you plant it, from it come 700 seeds. Seven branches, seven spikes, each one of them containing 100 seeds. So what is the return on investment? 700 times. 700 is the return on investment. Now, sometimes, you know, now is the age, the era of investing and cryptos and BTC, and you have all of these stocks, right? And sometimes we talk about exponential growth. We talk about return on investment. And if we hear 700% year over year, that is just so awesome. Well, this ayah is not talking about annualized return on investment. This is talking about every single time that you spend. Subhanallah. How beautiful, how powerful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us this example. My sights are on the clock. I want to make all of these reminders under 10 minutes. I hope that you are benefiting. And if you found this presentation beneficial, consider sharing it amongst all of your social media networks so that people would gain some benefit and come closer to their maker, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the ayah has not ended. Allah azza wa jal now says, and he continues, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ, and Allah increases for whomever he wills. Allahu Akbar. Allah increases for whomsoever he wills. Wallahu wasi'un alim. And indeed, Allah is all encompassing in his knowledge. Now, there are at least five different lessons, but due to time constraints, I'll share just a few with you that we can extract from this ayah. The first lesson is, what is the best place? What's the best stock that we can invest in? It is the stock that will bring the highest obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear listeners, we are living at a time when the pandemic is raging. There are people amongst us in our midst who are suffering from food insecurity, who are suffering from problems, right, of a financial nature. Seek them out. Look for them. Look for organizations that you can donate to that are doing meaningful, impactful work at the grassroots level, locally in your communities. Follow them. And inshallah, if you follow me on my Instagram channel, you will find some of these organizations, inshallah ta'ala. And I urge you to seek them out, to spend in that path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because this brings the highest return of investment. The next point that we see is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us a mental image. What's the point in Allah talking about this one seed and seven ears and 700 grains? It's so that you and I get a glimpse, a taste of how Allah will grow our wealth. The third point of benefit that we see from this is the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't think that when Allah increases for us, Allah will have some deficiency in his kingdom or in his resources. No, no, no. Wallahi, no. Allah will never have any diminishing of his own resources. Another point that we see is ikhlas. The place where this money is coming from your heart, when you're spending with pure sincerity, that much more will be the multiplication of your reward. My time is up. I hope that you benefited from this reminder. Tune in every single Friday, and throughout the week, I do live streams, and you can catch all of them on my YouTube channel, on my Instagram, on my Facebook page. Make sure you're following them. Spread the word far and wide. I beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he accepts from you and I, that he makes us from those who have this beautiful characteristic of spending in his path so that we gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We beg Allah that he forgives all of those who have passed away due to this pandemic, that he accepts them as shuhada, as martyrs, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants them his Jannatul Na'im, and those who are alive, that Allah grants all of us the tawfiq to lead our lives and to live our lives according to his teachings in his book and according to the teachings of his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Take very good care of yourselves. Until next time, wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.